Hey everybody, I am Cinnamon Cooney, your Art Sherpa, and on the mic today, co-hosting with me is my husband John.
Hey guys.
He does that because, you know, this is complicated, has a bunch of cameras and requires robotic operation, and also he's got to read the comments from you because this is a live art class.
Is live. What does that mean, live?
That means like it's happening right now in real time unless you're here on replay, and then you get to be excited to find out, did it all work out or did I fall down?
Ooh.
I'm going to be teaching these grape vines today based on stained glass windows.
Ooh.
So I'm going to show you how easy this is. This is really great, even if you're really new at creativity, you're a new painter, because we've got traceables, we've got some processes for this that make this really, really easy. So no matter where you are in your paint journey, this is going to work for you. And once you learn this technique, you can do it with almost any coloring page or stained glass pattern.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
So can I ask you a question there while you're taking
you
a sip?
You can ask me any question while I sip a sip.
If you were going to say grade this on a scale of 1 to 3 hoots in difficulty, 1 being the easiest hoot, 3 being the most difficult, what would you say it is?
I think if you try to freehand this sucker, it's going to get near a 3 hoot. It's kind of a complicated drawing.
Yeah?
I think if you trace it in.
Yeah?
It's like a hoot and a half, 2 hoot.
Is it okay?
You know, you should have done some painting because we're going to do some dry brushing and some stonework here. I'm going to show you how to create this great stone window effect. And then I'm also show you this trick to make it look like a stained glass window that's lit up from behind. So those, like, you want to have done a couple paintings so you're not like, it's a brush, it's paint,
gotcha.
What's going on?
So either a couple of paintings in or a beginning painter with some good drawing experience.
Yeah. I mean, like, you used to paint, but it's been a little while and you're just trying to refresh. This is actually a good project.
Good. Okay, cool.
I personally think.
So you got your sippy cup there?
Sippy coffee.
Can you show us that? That's pretty neat. It says paint water, not. Show me the other side
of
it.
It says paint water. Me? Not paint water.
That's pretty cool. I like that one. And you can get that on the Sherpa shop, which is shop.theartsherpa.com. Gratuitous plug.
Gratuitous plug. Shameless self-promotion. Today,
what do you got there?
I've got burnt sienna, cad yellow, phthalo blue, phthalo green, dog's eating purple, naphtha red, titanium white, Australian sienna. But look, guys, you could use Indian yellow, or if you just didn't have this, you could just do the cad yellow the whole way through.
Yeah.
I'm just being fussy because I like it. And I've also got carbon black fluid paint. Now, on this, I would say, really seriously, for these kinds of projects, consider getting some good fluid paint. Think about it. It doesn't have to be this brand, but you would want a soft body paint. Guess what, though?
What's that?
Craft paint is soft body paint.
Is it?
Yeah. Just the stuff in the bottles that you shake up. So it doesn't have to be super expensive, but it does need to be the right product. I think that's an important thing to realize in art. It doesn't have to be super expensive, but you do want it to be the right product.
So while you got that, while you're putting out your paint there.
I'm going to put out some of this fluid paint. Oh, isn't that nice? Can you see how that just puddles out and starts to what's called self-level? I'm going to show you all the traceable.
Oh, the traceable. Where's it at?
Traceable. As I move my picture over. I've already traced this image on.
Okay.
But how this basically works, and I've done this and demoed this in a bunch of things. You would print out your traceable from me, the free traceable that I provide to you. Free.
Free?
Free. Mostly because I just don't want you to be aggravated beyond figuring out how to size your traceable.
Mm-hmm.
Which I don't really have a tutorial for. You got to go get a tech thing about resizing images for that. Because I don't know your computer or your software. But so you get your traceable, right? However you do it. And then I like to do this. I just rub pencil or graphite or something smudgy on the back.
Yeah.
Flip it over, trace over all the lines. I like to tape it all down so it doesn't move on me. Look at this, it's a hot mess. So I like to tape it all down so it doesn't move on me. And then I have a faint image there.
Ooh.
And I will often, you know, neatly come in there and fix it with some, you know, something darker. And here's the deal. I'm going to use these brushes here. Look at these little brushes. These are not pricey, right? They're wonderful, but they're not pricey. And they're small, and what they all basically are is a size 0, either a shader or a bright. I just want a little one to make little lines. Little lines.
And, you know, it's been
pretty. That doesn't shed a bunch of hairs.
So, now, you've got some wishes already in the canvas there?
I do. Thank you for reminding me.
Okay.
I almost completely blew that, didn't I?
You did, yes. Tell me about your wishes.
Okay. So, I have a wish. This is based on a story I read in Angeluni of a mother and daughter who got to come back together through art that made us all, like, crying. This is so beautiful. It was like better than anything in Chicken Soup for the Soul.
Mm-hmm.
I wish for all families that are separated, friends that are separated, anyone that's separated from somebody they love to just come back together and be reunited.
Yeah.
for Tapeface, who is a very serious member of our community, but today wishes to be called Tapeface.
Yes.
And we just indulge her in anything she wants. We and wish that she feels better.
Yep.
And heals. And you'll have to ask Janine whose birthday it is. Happy birthday, Janine.
Yes.
Janine in Australia. And we have another birthday.
We do.
Amber Hale. So Amber. Happy birthday to you. That's all singing I will do.
We had a quick request for one to squeeze in there for Maureen for a successful eye surgery.
Oh, yes.
She's hoping this is her last one. This is the third one.
You have eye surgery. My mom has eye surgery. I had a heel in there for my mom, too.
And we got one in for Lisa there to get her to get well. So she
Honey,
can...
that was tape face.
All right.
You weren't in on the joke?
No.
That's a wow joke. And he's was
I don't
okay.
get on it.
So anyway, so that was Lisa. So Amber, we have a wish for Mona. And we have a wish for Tammy. Community member Tammy. Man, she's gone through a lot today. Like this week, there's just been a lot of loss. And we're just wishing for strength for her. And we have a wish for Marilyn's daughter is having a baby. And we just wish that's all very happy. Right? I think.
Is that all of them?
That's them. Let's ink this in.
You know, we have so many inside jokes that I'm not even part of the
You're
inside jokes.
Not even part of the inside joke. Tape face was Lisa. It was just supposed to be. She was supposed to be all tickled that she was called Tape Face.
I'm sure she will be.
All I'm going to do is take this black paint and everywhere I have a line.
I'm going to zoom in on that.
Right? It takes me forever. So if you were ever like, man, I can never catch up. Here's your moment.
Oh, you're just going to be...
Here's your moment. Just live in your moment. I'm going to switch to this brown one.
Now, did you know that we've had over 300 people since we started here?
300 people? You're about to watch me line a painting.
It's just... So we started out being Sherpa. So
we started out being Sherpa. I'll do a dance as soon as this is lined. I'll do it. I did it dance. So on this one, I did another painting in the style of a Sacred Heart.
Did you?
Yeah, because it's such a pretty stained glass window. But we time-lapsed through this part.
Oh, yeah.
Which we never do. We never time-lapse. If we do, it's because something is just...
Where are you going?
I'm just involved, but maybe it'll help you. All I'm going
to
do...
You are just jumping all over the canvas today. I go to the top, you go to the bottom. It's like I'm
this
not...
one. I'm gonna just power through. I'm a power level through it. Is what I'm gonna do.
Okay.
I'm looking for lines.
I'm not even gonna go over. I know all you're doing is getting black here. So I'm just.
Yeah. Don't even worry about what I'm doing over there, guys. All I'm doing is getting black. Nothing interesting is happening at the palette yet. I'm not gonna worry that much about this black line because when I put the paint in, it messes it up anyways. And a lot of times at the end, I gotta clean it all up.
Now what?
This method works on any coloring book page.
Now, what kind of brush are you using?
Is it I am a using a Zero Studio Bright. Sterling Silver okay, so Studio
it's,
Bright.
It's a Zero Bright.
Yeah. That's what I'm using. And I'm right now just outlining my little brickies that I have traced in. What am I going to do when I come back with the other stones? Guess what? It's all going to change anyway, so I'm not even going to take it that seriously. Don't take it too seriously at this stage. I love sometimes when you're new at painting and you get into this stuff, you get real drilled in. You're like, oh no, it's lining. Yeah, just do it. Just let it go. Let it go, let it go. Sorry. I apologize to you, wherever you are in the world. John is trying to make the cameras be better. Sometimes my lines
sometimes
get crooked. If they do what I do, like that kind of went downward, I just thicken the line and I'll just paint over it to straighten it back out. This is my big problem in the window, is being a good stonemason.
Now we'll
a
have
terrible
to,
stonemason.
We'll have to adjust the camera again a little later after you get your base color on there. But for right now, I've...
Oh, yeah, because the first one is so dark.
Yeah, it's so...
To do this stone technique, this is layers, like onions and layers and ogres and layers, so many layers. There's so many layers, guys. And it's just really about just getting it in and not being too mental about it. I wouldn't do the coloring books or stained glass patterns that are overly fidgety. I wouldn't get any fidgetier, that's a technical term in art, than this. Because you'll just be just wondering why you started it. You're like, why? Why did I take up creativity? It was supposed to lower my blood pressure. relieve my stress. Then I picked this project, and I realized I've just misjudged everything in my life.
What?
So you get like that sometimes in some projects. You get in a project. You do. You get in an art project that seems like a good idea from the outside, and then you're in it, and then you realize that you have misassessed everything. And I know everybody out there has had that moment. I get in them. I start a thing, and I think, I don't mind painting your Morgan car among penguins in the Arctic. Do you remember that project, John? Because that stuck with me for life. Tell you that right now. What are you not going to see on this channel? A Morgan car with penguins in the Arctic? Ever.
That's a weird request.
It was a weird request, but you know what? When you take commission work, which I now know not to do, I am not a good commission artist. And you would think I would be, because I can draw anything people ask on command, right? We'll have to do a viewer-directed painting for people to just shout things out and I paint it. I can do that.
You're sort of like, you know, someone who can take excellent direction, but has a deeply ingrained, you know, resistance to authority figures.
No, I think it was just a terrible idea for a car, and it was really big. Remember, he wanted it to be giant for his loft?
Oh, yeah, no, I remember.
Sometimes you get in a project, and you're like, why am I here? What?
So you got a lot of, there's a lot of.
There's a lot, guys. I'm sorry. This is why normally we do these VOD, but we're gonna line together today because it's going to help you when you convert those coloring books, when you convert those stained glass patterns.
It seems to me that perhaps we should have, you know, had a little, you know, like on the cooking shows where we go.
I thought about that seriously.
Ta-da! And there's one that's already
lined. And we often do, but then you know what we get?
What do we get?
Messages were like, I needed to see what you were doing, and then you just flipped it. So tell John all of it for next time cooking show method.
Cooking show.
I don't think we're but 15 minutes in this whole lining project, though, to be really honest. Incredibly unwise for YouTube? Of course it is.
We're just going to talk to you guys while we're doing it, though.
So when I was designing this, one of the things I really looked at was actual stained glass art and how cuts had to be made. And this is certainly not perfect because I am not a stained glass artist. But believe it or not, cuts of glass are very specific.
Yeah.
And there's some stuff that they can do and a bunch of stuff that they cannot do. And so it was really interesting looking at how glass was created.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, glass is interesting. A branch right there. But
that's
this is
really
and
cool.
I don't line this in as neatly as I could going in because I know I'm going to be cleaning it up. What?
Steffi's like, can I pay someone to outline mine?
Dude, you know what? You're going to be sitting there going, I don't know what this is.
It's really not terribly difficult.
Mm-mm. It's
you
not.
Can do it.
And it's like a Zentangle. You will. It's good for your blood pressure, actually, this work.
Yeah.
Is good for you. If you've had a particularly challenging week and you had a particularly challenging people in your life.
Now, are you doing that on canvas or a canvas board?
This is an 11 by 14 canvas board.
Okay.
And I get asked a lot if canvas board is better than canvas. And the answer is absolutely not. They are different. And that is all. It's just that canvas board is different than canvas. Canvas has a drum, and that spring can be lovely and energetic to paint on. And it creates a certain movement in a painting that's quite lovely. But guess what? The board's stability means that I can do all kinds of gels and mediums and crazy things on it, including really rest my wrist while I'm doing a long lining project. And what is she doing? And that's our dog. And he's chewing something. If it all goes black, she just found the right cable. Scary. Aren't you scared? I'm scared. So I'm just following these little lines.
Sweet,
that's
so
all I'm doing.
I was just reading chat here. We got a bunch of new people joining us. So
Cassandra's
first time
here.
What?
Does everybody get what I'm doing here?
The outlining?
outlining. Does it? You would do Q and A right now.
Oh yeah, that's what I was saying. Is that we have some new viewers here. Cassandra's first time here. Her daughter loves. She got paints for Christmas and loves painting with you.
Oh, awesome! Hi, Cassandra. Hi to your daughter.
Her daughter's Natalie.
Hi, Natalie.
Hi, little brush. So I'm sure we've got some other little brushes here. I'll have to scroll up and see who's. I'm sure Raven's out there floating around. I'm not sure who else is up and going tonight. Well, let's see here.
Go ahead and read on out the comments, babe. Because I'm just lining. So we might as well hear what's happening in the world.
Why outline first and not at the end? Won't the colors mess up the black line if you overlap?
So, honestly, this black line is your saving grace and anchor. And you can always go back and clean up the line. But it's really tough to try to puzzle this in without it.
Gotcha. So it's you may need to come back and touch up the line, but it's necessary there for you to have guides to begin with.
You really might need it.
Gotcha.
You really do. Or you'll just get lost in the piece. Overly complicated pieces, you need to find things that help you create stability mentally and emotionally in the piece.
Now, why did you choose this grape pat? This grape sort of... theme, what made you, or this whole stained glass thing, Reagan McKenzie was, I guess it's McKenzie Reagan, was asking, you know, what made you inspired to do this?
You guys did, the community did. So I love to see what my community, see here I am like trying to figure out my own pattern. I always love to see what you guys are up to in your lives. And one of the things that I heard people expressing was a feeling of competency or comfort when coloring. That one did not experience when painting. And I just thought, well, you know, there's whole painting projects we can do that are just like coloring. Where we can make our own coloring pages. And then I adore stained glass, but I can't make it.
Ooh, I see Little Brush Taylor. Or Tyler. I'm sorry, Tyler. And Annabeth. And Trish, and who else is out there? Who else is out there? Little brushes. I've got. I'm trying to scroll up. Her chat is hopping tonight. It's going
is
pretty
it?
Fast.
I
want to
hear the chat. I'm excited. I'm just trying.
There's a lot of people
I'm
saying
trying
hello.
To not get lost in my own lines, and that's the hardest thing is to.
Well, I you know
to
I'm
not get lost.
I'm kind of letting you get through your lines there.
No, I can talk and do that. I'm just letting just so everybody know that that's something I'm having to do if they're feeling like they have to do that.
Yeah, we got over 384 people here. So, and I mean, just from all over the world. I mean, Danielle just came in. She's from Brazil. She says
hello. Hi, Danielle
hello.
From, or is it hola?
No, she said hello.
Oh,
so,
hello.
Maybe it's both.
Maybe it's both. I want to go to Brazil. There's a space there. They have a new space that they just opened up in Brazil. They have one in São Paulo, but they're opening a new one up in Brazil.
Millie and Josie are up too. So they're watching. Hi, Millie. Hi, Josie.
Hi, Millie and Josie.
And I'm sure Raven's around here. I think I saw her earlier up there. So. Oh, what was it? What was that I saw up here? Oh, I Mackenzie, she said I got her name right. Yeah, don't count on that happening correct all the time. And there's lots more coming on the Sherpa Mobile. You can stay tuned for that. We'll post some more up on that.
Oh, are there questions about the Sherpa Mobile?
Yeah, but we're
going to watch the video and wonder
you
why.
You got to wonder. There's going to be more coming on that. So
why would anyone do this?
Why? Yeah. So, but you know, it's there's some fun stuff happening on that.
So, what are they, you know, saying?
Oh, well, so everyone right now is saying hello to everyone else.
I love when they're like, "Hi, how are you?"
Hello to. Oh, and wow, that's pretty cool. Maria just found a big wad of surprise in her garage. She came into a little money there that she wasn't planning on. So congratulations to that. That's awesome. Fine.
Like an actual bag of money?
Well, I think, yeah, she had some money that's put away there that she came back upon and was like, woohoo, look what I found.
Oh, okay.
You know,
that's like my mom's fantasy is to find like a bag of money.
Somebody just came and deposited one in your garage?
Yeah. That would scare the crud out of me because I watch TV.
You roll up the garage door and there's just like a briefcase.
I would just be like,
in the middle
this
of the
is the beginning of every suspense drama ever.
Dun, dun. It starts with those two, you know, those two notes.
Yeah, dun dun, or that trumpet.
So, Natasha says hello from Nova Scotia, Canada. So hello,
hi, Natasha from Nova Scotia, Canada.
How you doing? And Renee is from Missouri. I see there.
Hello, Missouri.
And Patrick from New Zealand. Wow.
Wow, that's
Ashley
so cool. Hi, Patrick from New Zealand.
Claire in the UK. Wow, there's people from all over the place coming in and saying hello.
I feel like, you know, the RV's not going to be enough. I feel like we got to go world tour.
I think it's going to need jetpacks and an amphibious landing package.
Just seriously. If that were an option, we would so A-team it everywhere.
It would be awesome. Sherpamobile crosses the Atlantic. Oh, man. You guys don't know how deep this dork forest really is.
You really don't.
I mean, it may be a preserve at some point. It's so deep.
We're almost exactly like a painting party tonight, babe.
Oh, yeah.
This is about the painting party speed. If you've ever been wanting to do a painting party, this is about the speed that they go, because usually they have you paint in the background, and then that's very chill for a while, and then you...
Little Brush Ileana says hello. She's 10.
Hi, Ileana.
She loves your hat.
Oh, thank you.
Ooh, and Saltwater Joys is from New Brunswick.
Saltwater Joys, one of the admins in Angeluni.
Oh, hello.
How you doing, sweetie?
So.
She's pretty cool. She's a really good artist.
Hello, everybody.
She should be in the Art Sherpa ATC so we can all trade art.
Oh, yeah. Debbie from Toronto.
Toronto.
And Cindy says she's got her new easel set up and she's ready to rock and roll.
Is she?
Uh-huh. Kim Zim, are we going to paint the Sherpamobile? I think the Sherpamobile erupts in a galaxy fire of pink and purple on its own. So we'll just have to stay tuned to see what happens.
It's just... So much to come.
Yeah.
So much to cap in.
Oh, so yeah. Oh, and Narda? She's from Galveston. Local girl here.
Dude, you got to come to one of the local meetups, man. Mm-hmm.
Yep, definitely one of the short lists to get out there to the...
Definitely got to do, like, a local meetup.
Oh, this is a good question.
I love good questions. Give me any question. So any question.
Tammy just wanted to let you know there's 402 people watching. Okay. And
do we have bubbles for that?
We probably do. Joanne would like to know, could you use a Sharpie when outlining this?
Okay. So I would hate to say no, because I think you could probably get away with it. I think the issue with the Sharpie is the silver metallic green to the ink. And the fact that it'll fade out on you over time, but I think you could probably get away with a Molotov paint pen as well. So if you wanted to get a Molotov paint pen or an oil paint pen or any of those, I think you could do that as well. Oh, he's setting up the bubbles, so. But I mean, you know, if you're just doing an art project to enjoy putting together an image... the Sharpie should set well enough to be painted over and not lift into the paint. And that would be the thing that I would test, is make sure the ground is holding the pen.
Does it work?
What? It doesn't work? That's the sadness in my life. If bubbles don't work, I don't know how I'm going to go on. Oh, there. See, that's how I know life is basically good, even though, you know, things that might happen that make us sad. I like to go around, and I call this leading.
Yeah.
Anything that's round would be heavily leaded, and so I like to go around and lead it with my black paint. See how I kind of strengthen those?
Oh, yeah.
You know, and they might still need it after, but I just like to make sure, because these are sort of little decorative pieces that get inset. I really love my bubbles. All right, let's do a little jam, because I'm mostly through it.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Some quick.
Just got a little bubble jam on. So you're in the slow part of the refrain from the bubble jam. But I wanted to say thank you to all you guys who are coming out and hanging out with us. It really is cool. We got over 400 people here with us today. It's like 413 people right now. So I just wanted to say so, you know.
Gotta do that a little bit careful, because you...
Cinnamon does the power dab and knocks herself out on the easel.
And that's how you know it's live. Strip it down.
So thank you guys for coming and joining us. We really, really appreciate you guys being here with us, and just love having you for these parties and this hanging out. And, you know, if you can't get up and dance, then don't forget to wiggle your fingers and wiggle your toes, because that's what being alive is all about. So...
Being alive is dancing in bubbles.
And bubbles.
We should all have a bubble machine.
We should.
I have so much soap on my palette paper.
I see that over there. It's like
I'm going to put out my paint colors now.
We're going to see how glycerin affects it.
Oh, we're learning.
We're
Remember
learning.
That the Australian Sienna, which could also be Indian yellow, is optional, so don't get stressed on it. And you could use any good bright crimson in this red. You could probably even get away with a quinacridone magenta too here.
A Passamaquoddy pink?
Passamaquoddy pink, man.
Oh.
Try to, like, one of the best things about doing the big art quest is just knowing what paints you could probably exchange and get away with so you don't have to buy something new. Unless you want to.
Yes.
If you want to, then definitely go out and get it.
Mm-hmm. So we're going to...
Definitely.
So I think CPG just joined us tonight. He thinks that everybody...
Is Chris plays games in the house?
He is. He said...
You're looking at my palette, but...
He says, bubble machines for everybody.
Bubble machines for everybody.
I think he needs a bubble machine on
bubble
his show.
Bubble machines for everybody.
We should
have a dream where Chris plays games and I collaborate.
You could do a bubble collab.
We can do a bubble collab. Do game collab. Go to the space. Go live from the space. We could take control of one of those weird little robot facey things. And go bug other spaces.
The telepresence robots.
Yeah. Like, whereas I wouldn't have confidence to just kidnap one and go running around, I feel like he would.
Yeah. Well, he knows how to use them all.
Yeah. He would look so official, they wouldn't even, like, question it. They'd be like, yeah, no, he's totally supposed to have that. Right? I'm going to get a nice little bright out. I'm going to get a number 6 bright.
Oh, look, I was on the right camera at the right time. Check that out. Number 6 bright's all.
Number 6 bright, because it's just nice. It's the right size. It's not too small. If I had a really small brush, it'd be too fussy and too long. If I had a big brush, I'd be working it, making it happen.
Now, this is an 11 by 14 canvas?
This is an 11 by 14 canvas. I'm taking a little of my phthalo blue over to my burnt sienna, and I might even grab a little of this black and mix it in there. I know. Crazy biz we're doing, and we're going to paint in all around our black line. And this is such a chromatic color, it's almost a complete chromatic black, so you may find it's even hard to see around your black line. But you got to start, if you're going to do stonework, castle stonework, you want to start with this nice dark color. It's pretty easy to do, you just want to start with a nice dark color. Color it all in. All these outer corners here. Just enjoy.
Tia wants to know if is there going to be a bubble machine on the RV? Of course there is.
Oh my gosh, there needs to be one on the roof, right? Well, like a bubble cannon?
Well, I was planning on right on the, you know, the rear vent port that goes out the roof in the back.
Yeah.
I was planning on just having a bubble pipe that shoots straight out the back, so as we're going down the freeway, it can just emit bubbles right
out
the top.
Oh my gosh, this dream is the best dream. This is the best dream anybody ever dreamed.
Hey, Lisa came into chat just to say hello.
Oh, how is Kate Face doing?
I think she's doing okay. Someone just said, Lisa's here.
Good.
Hey, Lisa.
Glad she is feeling better. I'm going to add a little tiny bit of white.
And everyone would like me to let you know, you have hit double Sherpa.
No.
You just totally have just blown it away.
You guys are the best.
You guys really are.
The best. The best, the best, the best. Are you being great and painting in little dark stones?
Yeah.
They're going to love it. It's like a magic trick how easy these are to go together. Even if you never put a stained glass window, even if you're like, I'm just going to put daisies in all my windows from now on. Just getting the stone technique is completely worth it for art journaling or card making or painting. Just whatever you're working on creatively. And I like the coloring aspect of this. Like, I color my lines. Right?
Oh, there are some questions here asking about...
Answering we will.
Whether or not we got our mail. So we have gone to the mail. We've got some more stuff. We're going to be doing another mail show soon?
Yeah, I think we have to. And I think
maybe this weekend.
We've been talking about doing another You Guys Tell Me What to Paint show.
A viewer-directed paint.
Yeah.
And
some new YouTube features we've got to test, and we think it would be perfect for a You Tell Me What to Do.
We'll try that maybe tomorrow, maybe this weekend.
We got that parent university to go to.
After we're done.
Good parents.
After we're done being good parents, we'll see if we can be bad parents and go live.
I want to be a good parent. Why Did school give me work to do?
Well, that's pretty cool. You know, so you guys know what we're talking about. Tomorrow, we're attending a parent training seminar at the school where they come in, they teach us the school work that the kids are doing and give us good habits to help, you know, teach our kids.
I have to go learn new math.
And for that, our kid gets she gets extra credit points.
That's why we're going.
So I thought that was pretty cool. So so we have Melanie's new here. So she says hello.
Hello.
And Kathy's like, is there going to be another show tomorrow?
There might be.
There might be.
Might be Sunday. Depends on how we're doing. Depends on if they suck our will to live right out of us.
Yeah. Ooh, Debbie.
Junior high isn't just hard on the junior high people. It's hard on the parents of junior hires.
Debbie was like, please, something gothic soon this way.
The stone this window is not that gothic? I don't know.
You guess you could gothic
this up cheerful. Someone. The heart was pretty gothic. It's a bleeding, flaming heart with wire around it.
Lisa, she's like, you guys are going live tonight, so you don't have to go live tomorrow. Why are you going live again tomorrow?
Lisa's just missing us. She's like, you can't go live without me.
She can't. I don't know.
We went rogue. Rogue one.
We just go rogue all the time.
Could paint rogue one. That's what I could do. We haven't done one of the, you know, showing us how to do it. So you can just see I'm just painting this in. This is why we do these a lot on VOT. Because we're like, look, paint all the stones in.
Yeah, it's all the same. Just one stone after the other stone. Subtle differences.
This is exactly what Chris means about, like, tutorials versus art teachers.
Yeah.
So if you are a YouTuber and you are watching this right now, don't do this. This is not the way to teach this. Not best practices by any means. So excited. I'm having the best time now. I like painting in my stonework. It's like my own coloring page. I like that it's not just Ozzy Osbourne now who has a coloring page. We all have a coloring page in our heart. So the trick is I've got to get it dark, and it's getting too light on me, and I've got to darken it back up again.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want it to lighten up, because otherwise then my happier, lighter, moldier stonework won't be as interesting. And I want it to still be interesting stonework, right?
Yes.
Fun stuff that we can do.
So given that we have our stuff tomorrow, are we going to, we want to set up, we need to make a decision on if we're going to go on Sunday.
We need to make a decision?
Yeah, because Lisa's right. If we're gonna talk about it, we've got to commit to something.
This is our number one thing that we control for.
We are legitimately bad, because it's like we want to go live all the time, but we don't. Like, life happens, and then we
can't. Well, we have faster projects. Like, we've got those nice grapes coming up.
Yeah, we do.
They're not grapes. They're wisteria. Why did I say grapes?
Because you're painting grapes, and you got grapes on the brain. So, all right. So, what do we say? You want to say Sunday? That way we have tomorrow to do our work?
All right.
We'll do Sunday.
Let them vote. Can they vote?
No, I think we just create more.
More problems?
You're like, I want to pick a poll. If Cinnamon.
You know I love a poll.
If Cinnamon, if she would take a poll to find out what we're going to poll on. She's just like, you know.
I'm like, you want to stop me in my tracks? Give me an internet poll. That's me for the whole day.
I'll poll anything.
That's how I know how the world is, man. I polled it.
You did. It's like you got to know what everybody thinks. Oh, it's a Super Bowl Sunday. Like,
oh, then no. We'll see you tomorrow. I'm not willing to take on Super Bowl.
I wonder, do you think we're going to have any energy tomorrow?
Here's the thing. I'm just saying that no. I mean, who's going to be here? It's Super Bowl.
It's not happening on Super Bowl Sunday.
I mean, we don't watch football, but other people might watch football.
Yeah.
I don't know. I can't see the chat.
They're like, yes for anything. Yes, it's Super Bowl Sunday is going to be kind of tough because everyone's going to be partying on Sunday, so we don't want to go live against Super Bowl. That's probably a good thing.
All right, we'll go live Saturday night.
You're gonna do it Saturday. She's just, and Nay, I'll say tomorrow. Not on Sunday. Definitely not on Sunday.
We'll do it tomorrow. But what are we doing tomorrow?
I don't know. What are we doing? We have mail. We have a lot of mail.
We do mail all the time.
We're just getting in so much trouble over here. You know that.
You know, Lisa's trying to recover, and this isn't good for her, John.
No, this is not. This is not good for her at all.
We're not helping her healing. And we're going to get an angry message. Well, you are. I'm not going to go near the computer is what I'm going to do. So you notice I'm just doing these sort of gray greens. My gray is bluish or greenish. This is very important for this cold castle stone. And it's really actually getting castles and you think to yourself, man, that's not cozy. It's fortified, but it's not cozy.
Yeah.
It takes some tapestries and some fires to make a castle cozy. That's what I'm saying. Any questions going on? We're still doing the long paint. This is one of those things where we just painted in. This was a longer one. We've been asked for a longer one, though, for a while.
So.
Y'all know I can do it real time in 20 minutes, right?
Oh, yeah. Well, there's a bunch of Super Bowl smack talking happening in chat that I'm trying.
Tell me sports or some sports.
It's my sports guy is better than your sports guy, and my color sports team is better than your color sports team, which I think is, I think it's Patriots, and I don't actually know who's playing in the Super Bowl. So I'm just sort of trying to catch up. There's a puppy bowl apparently going on tomorrow, which does have some interest. I might check
that
out.
A puppy bowl?
A puppy bowl.
Is that the Westminster puppy bowl?
You know what? It probably is.
That I'll watch.
I think that they were having cats in it. I heard
that's
some rumor
just wrong.
That they were having cats in there.
I love cats. I do. But at Westminster, what has come to the world? No, it's all good. It's all good. I got cat love. I got dog love. Got love for everybody. I just don't have time to get into this crazy not love everybody thing.
Yeah, Ashley was like, John, do you guys catch the puppy bowl? I'm like, I don't know what it is. If it's Westminster, then you get some. Oh, Falcons and the Patriots.
I don't know who any of those
people
are.
I don't even know where
those
guys are.
But understand, we moved to Canada and did not know why everyone had facial hair. We just thought it was like a Canadian thing. John's like questioning, like, do I got to grow facial hair?
Okay, so I knew that it's the New England Patriots, not because I knew about football, but because I knew about New England. And, you know, I don't know. Why is it that New England gets a team and, you know, we can't just say, like, you know, we just get a bunch of other states together and we'll call them, you know.
Is it happening here in Houston? Is this the Super Bowl in Houston? Or where is it located at?
I don't know.
I'm just saying because there was that whole thing about rent out your house.
I don't know.
For the Super Bowl. Nobody's going to our house. We don't have one of those houses.
This is like one of the things. Like, I could answer so many more questions if this were about like almost any other thing. Oh, the Patriots are from Massachusetts. See, even there I was wrong.
Wow.
See, I'm just like,
hey, John.
Well, Massachusetts
in a GMC motorhome, in a 1975 GMC motorhome. What makes that motorhome unique? Why is that special?
Yeah, so that's
I'm trying to help you out here. I'm throwing you one, babe.
Yeah.
I'm throwing it to you.
Okay, so she says yes in Houston.
Woohoo! In Houston. So I also need to not leave the house then.
Apparently on Sunday we're not going anywhere.
We aren't going anywhere Sunday anyways.
So you got, like, I have no idea.
All I'm saying is, look, the underpainting of the stone is in. Look how awesome we are.
No, what colors are you using there to get that stone?
So I try to vary up a mix on this particular stonework of the phthalo blue, burnt sienna, and sometimes I'll add a little even of this black into it to darken it up. Now, I'm going to wipe my brush out because I want a fairly dry brush. And I'm going to come and add a little white into this grayed mixture that I've made. Right?
Huh. Okay, so, all right, so now I'm...
And you can even grab a little of this yellow just to warm it up, get crazy with it, right? And I'm going to start coming here and just dry brushing. And here's the technique with this, is that you need the paint underneath to be dry. It can't be wet anymore. And you need your bristles to be stiff. You can use natural bristles or a good synthetic. And you're going to use a very light pressure as you brush over the top texture of what your canvas, your board, whatever it is. And you can do this without stucco or an underlying texture to create this effect. Though if you had stucco or had done the stucco, this is a great time to enjoy it. See how we're doing that?
Cool. So they just want to make sure that, I think the question was here, is they wanted to make sure that they got the stone colors there. So
phthalo blue, yeah. Burnt sienna, sometimes a little bit of black and white to lighten so you could still see it at all.
Okay.
So I'm going to add a little brown, a little blue to this, keep stoning it up, lightening. And I'm going to come here and I'm going to just dry brush this cornerstone. What is this one called?
Keystone?
Keystone, thank you.
Okay.
Do you know you're actually supposed to cover that in art class?
What's that? Architecture? Okay.
Yeah, you have to. Because somehow those things are related.
Well, art history, yeah. Well, I mean, like, yeah. Architecture, yeah, is a big part of
art.
Art, yeah. Because they were the things that they were. Buildings were sticking around for a while when they made them out of stone.
Well, it took generations to do them. And so you can see as I start to do this dry texture, and you'll notice I'm not getting... I might grab a little yellow here. I'm not getting... I'm not getting my brush wet, am I?
Yeah.
And you want it to feel different than what's underneath. So you can see why it's so important to have it be dark.
Ah.
Right? And I'm just going to just so quickly... go around with this light texture. So that wasn't showing up enough. Guess what you do? Get it lighter. Come in here, light whatever it is. You need to see the texture as you're lightening up the stone. So it needs to be dry over dry.
Yeah.
Needs to be layered. Right? Need a layer. Might get some brown into this now. Get some brown in there. Then browning that up. Stone has personality. Like when it digs out of the quarry, you know, it's been exposed to minerals, right?
Yeah.
I make myself comfortable by turning my canvas like you do. Well, I struggle. And I'm just going to keep dry brushing. You can see how letting the canvas show through underneath creates that stone effect. It's not hard. It's just time intensive. And the best stone is a couple of color stories thick. 2, 3, 4, 5. The more you're willing to come in and work a story, the more your stone's character is going to start to take shape.
Ah.
And that's a lot to say about stone. But it's true. See how easy that is? It's like magic. Totally works.
Yeah.
Totally works. Little brown grayed area goes beautifully over that. Can kind of make your brush stroke directionality interesting. If I do that, then it looks like it's kind of hewn, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
And that's nice. And you just play with those things that are nice.
Now, you're just dry brushing that on there, right?
I am just dry brushing this on. In fact, I'm avoiding my water pretty intensely so that the dry brushing is very effective.
Now, should you feel a dragging across the canvas?
Yeah, and you should hear... I don't know if the...
Let's turn this down.
Hear that?
Not really, yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's right.
I was trying to put my mic closer for y'all so you could just hear what I hear. Be in the studio with me. Hear what I hear. I'm grabbing a little of this brown. You know, I'm going to come get a little green. Mix it into my brown. Look at that. That's an interesting color, right?
Yeah.
Let's come here and add that interesting color up here in this corner. Layering. Don't be afraid to layer around your stones. And that's how you start to create character in them. You need more green? Get more green. Just getting this. And so this is an interesting darker color, but that's okay. So I'm trying to create this interest here.
Okay.
I'm going to just put this around. I'm just trying to show the weather, the moisture, the age of the castle. I'm going to come over a little yellow, a little... Look at that. A little yellow, a little burnt sienna. Look at that. Warm. It's not quite an ochre, but it has a very quarried feel. And that's what I'm trying to do, is create a quarried feel. And you just layer and layer and layer and layer and layer and layer and layer. Layer it.
So many layers.
So many layers. Are you done? No! Layer it. I got this nice green into that mix. I'm going to put that there, layering it. Find some stone. My brush has all this pigment. Look at this brush, completely covered with this different pigment. Just dropping that pigment somewhere. If you did the stucco wall with me, you're like, oh my gosh, this is my jam. I totally know how to do this. I love this jam. This is that dry brush jam. See? And you can go back through if you want with a very dark color. I'm adding a little black to this mixture I have over here. Right?
Mm-hmm.
On this bigger brush. And then you can come through and define the stone space. Look at this.
Oh, by darkening that a little bit.
Yeah, darken that space between them. Right over it.
Now, this was a viewer request, right? Community request painting?
I did this, and I had posted it. We were going to do a VOD, and then the VOD had an issue. And we didn't get it up, and I've been asked for this about 50 times. So I am saying, hey, sometimes we go live to make up for the VOD.
Oh, we're going to send some art hugs out to Rhonda.
Hi, Rhonda.
Give her some prayers and hugs. She's in the she's out there getting some her heart and sugar giving her some trouble.
Oh.
So she's out. She's watching us, I think, from the hospital right now. So
that is a bummer, but also kind of cool.
So, you know, sorry for your circumstances. Big art hugs. Hope you get better.
We just got one out of the hospital. Another one goes in. My new wish. All the Sherpas out of the hospital. Everybody just feeling happy and healthy. So you can just see we just, you know, add that. You can even put some of that darkness back into your stone.
Oh, yeah.
Right? You just can't go wrong with your stone. You just stone and stone, and then you can, like here you got just all this in the brush, and you can go into the white, and now you've got a high light gray. And you can just stone.
You could say you're stone cold crazy.
You can. Forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. And ever and ever. You can just go into this and just be like, I like anchor stones, and I cannot lie. I think we got the basic gist of this, don't we?
Mm-hmm.
What are we doing? What is this? This is stones. Well, oh. How do we get it? We layer it up. We layer, 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 layer.
So, Shaunista?
Mm-hmm.
This is her first time painting with us.
Awesome.
See us live. I've done a few paintings of cinnamon, but never been able to catch you live. So happy to just love y'all. Hi.
Oh, my goodness. You know what's gone cold on me and I totally need?
What you need?
My coffee. Did you ever realize that you may have not done your lipstick well and you're on a YouTube show? Does that
nope.
ever happen to you?
Never happened to me.
I'm sorry. I've been doing that all day. You had to be right at the house to get the joke. We're like, my kids say no. They say no to any of it. I'm so glad to be. You should never drink caffeine this late. And yet I'm doing it. How are we liking our stones? So many stones. I feel like the picture I sent him must have been pixelated. But you getting the gist of it? How much warmer is it? Drinkly? I don't know. Was it just a little warm?
More?
Full 30, babe. Full 30. He shorted me on the 30. Gave me two bubbles and he shorted me on a 30. What the heck? Come here. Say hi to everybody because they're waiting for me to get my coffee. Look at this. Look how big. Look how big. Look how big she is. She's so big. Not really. She's still only a few pounds. And she's so nice. She's nice. She's very sweet. She chews everything. She just finally had her last visit to the doctor, so. So excited for her. She gets her official tags and her collars and her bags, and she's so excited, and she's going to be able to go to the groomer and get a Bobo soon. Very excited. I'm just sharing my dog news with you. This is not that show, but you're getting that anyway.
That's what you get.
That's what you get. I'm going to get a small brush.
Are you?
I am. I'm going to get a very small brush. And I'm deciding between a bright and a round. And I'm going to start out with the round and see how that goes for me. This here is a number 4 round. And I'm going to get clean water. And I'm going to put in my grapes. So my grapes are an interesting combo of stuff. Like sometimes I want them to be like a little purple and some of this red. And I'm going to get white. And I'm going to really, really not overmix it. See how it's just like crazy on my brush? I'm going to dip a little bit in water. And I'm going to put some bright grapes around. And I'm going to let the paint be swirly. If I can get the paint to even have a little white swirly in it, it's very helpful. I'm going to do 3 up here. And you want streaks. I don't know if you've ever looked at glass that's for sale at the craft store, but it can have a lot of streaks in it. So I'm going to roll my brush off, reload all this at the tip, add a little white to the tip. See how that's all just loaded at the tip? I know it sounds like much more interesting than it is. Just putting a few of these colors, and you're going to want to put these bright colors around. I'm going to want to get some just very light. I need some white, white, white. They go right here. And you're going to want to put variances on the theme.
What? Jackie's like, are you live right now?
I'm live right now.
How can we prove to Jackie we're live right now?
I don't know how we can prove it to Jackie. I'm rinsing out my brush, Jackie.
Sure. Not sure. How are you? I'm not
this
sure.
This usually works pretty well, but you know, sometimes it doesn't. I'm going to get some purple and some white.
We promise we're live. How about that?
We're really, really trying to be so super truthful. A little bit of my red. And this is how I get the grapes in, is mixing up these colors. And just swirling it around like it's molten glass. I love glass artists. I don't know if anybody else likes glass artists. But I'm a huge fan.
We know Matt likes glass.
Yes, we know my friend Matt likes glass. Which is really kind of why we don't see Matt a lot. Because we have children and he loves glass. I have good kids. But not play next to glass good. They're very sweet people, but no. So it's just really fun to mix up all these different colors of purple around, and the more you can have it be swirly in the paint, the more it's going to feel like glass. Now I'm going to do a fun thing. One of my favorite color mixes in the universe is Dogsinine and Thalo together. Pop a little light and white into it and just go around and just have a blast. There's a little white streaking out. Isn't that fun?
Mm-hmm.
You need to make one of your grapes bigger. You can do that easily. You think it'd be hard, but it's not. It's easy. Here with this guy. Right? It's just always fun to sort of go around with these different little mixes and see where you can take it. And if you need a little water on the tip of your brush, tip your brush in the water and then just keep going. You could use a medium if you had one. And that's how you get these in. That is how you get this effect of these glass cabochons in the grapes. And add a little white, letting it be swirly. Swirly. What?
Swirliness.
Swirling. This is a Beavis and Butthead we're teaching in art class, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right now. Get some just purple. Because, you know, purple's important.
So Maddie was asking about where can I put wishes for the next show. So I think probably good places on our just post them up on our Facebook page or on their website. You can send those to us. Really,
a lot of times here our moderators will tell us, you know, too, when they see a wish go by and they're like, you gotta do something about that. We're like, okay, the moderators are really, really much more in charge than you think. We really listen to our mods.
Yeah.
Because it's a special group of people. These are people that understand the kind of community space we want to have. And now, they defend the borders.
Is this the underpainting?
No, actually, this is just like a coloring page.
Really?
So as we go through, when we finish it, we will finish it.
Gotcha. So this isn't like normally where you're like...
No, we're just coloring, man. And that's why we want it to be swirly and very loose. And just have fun with that. Just have fun. And every time you do it, the grapes will be a little different. The thing that you might go back and touch up.
Yeah.
That you don't know that you might is the black lining.
So Lisa was suggesting the best place for us to capture all those wishes is on the forum on the website.
Lisa's probably correct.
Yeah, I think that I agree with her that we'll make sure that there's a great forum thread in there for wishes. And you can go right in there and I'll do what I can here. We're doing a lot of updates on the website. So
as you guys know, the construction going by.
Lots of dust happening there on the site. But there's lots of new things out there too. So you should go out and check them out. Our chat's happening. It's going pretty well. There's a lot, you know, we've added a lot of functionality to the online chat. We've got a lot more functionality in the profiles for everybody. So some new tools like that will be coming in. But definitely go check that out. We've got our forums out there where you can submit your wishes, and we'll be able to keep track of those for next time. As I have just been notified.
And we're almost done with our grapes.
Now, what brush are you using there?
I am using a number 4 round.
A number 4 round.
You could probably get away with any round, small detail. I like the round because it lets me do these little swirls pretty easily. How do we like my grapes? I feel like they're
like
fairly stained glassy.
They're very cool.
Right? That one's quite blue. I like that one. It's very blue. And so you'll want that. You can even go through, like, if you need to add a little something in there.
A little something.
Now, I'm going to rinse this out, and I'm going to get into one of my brights. Probably grab another very clean number 6.
Number 6.
And I'm going to work this down area. This would be like the sky, like, that was shining through underneath the vines and leaves.
Oh, okay.
So I'm going to have a lot of fun here. You can get your just cad yellow if you want. Right? I'm going to use a little of my Australian Sienna. And I'm going to grab from the clean side some white, and you'll notice that I'm just beating up paint. See that?
Oh yeah.
And I'm going to very carefully, and I'm going to do everything I can to let it streak.
Ooh.
This will almost look like paint pouring. And the trick will be to not paint over. Right? To not paint over the streaks that I have, because this is what makes it feel like those little sheets of glass that you will see in a painting. If you lose it and overwork it, you can let it dry and take a second pass.
Would you just hair dry it and then just...
Yeah, I would just hair dry it and take a second pass at it. Just grab some white. See how I'm doing?
Uh-huh.
And I'm just... everything I can do to let it be streaky. Isn't that interesting?
Yeah.
Whoop. Got a drip there.
Did it run away?
It'll happen. And that is... See, isn't that interesting? Okay, I like that.
Yeah.
I like that a lot. So I might offload my brush. Maybe this one get a lot of white on there. Right? I've got this bead of white. Let me see if I can show it to you here. I'm going to do this piece.
Wait, zoom again.
See?
Yeah.
Where the pigment that's pulled up into the bristles, and then it's just sort of all there.
You're putting it right there?
All right. I'm just going to go right here. And you're going to notice that the pigment offloads into the white fairly well. Very streaky. I press down, more pigment disperses. And now you kind of get a sense of why it would just be easier to go back and fix any black lines you wanted back again. Because of the method that we get this effect. Just in a single stroke.
Oh, yeah.
I love this for that. I'm going to get some pure blue. Grab a little white. I'm going to come over here in the corner, right here. And you can see how it's much more blue. Similar thing, just trying to let the streaks be.
So I just dropped a link right there in our chat. We'll get it in the description below so that there's a place for you can go and put your wishes.
I just grabbed some purple.
We have our little wish form there.
So
you
guys can
drop those right in.
Oh, awesome. Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Well, we're almost like we know what we're doing.
Well, when we have, you know, a really awesome team, Lisa going back there behind the scenes, making sure that everything's... Even though she should be in bed.
Yeah, she really should be.
She should be.
Everybody tell her she should be in bed.
but she would like to let you know that you're a double-double Sherpa. You have 400-400 right now.
No, I feel like I've got to, like, do something again for that.
I think we have to say thank you to everybody because, gosh, man.
Thank you.
You guys rock.
This is my coffee that's been heated so he doesn't have to go back and heat it again. You guys do rock. Do you guys like how that's coming out?
There's just a group of people. There's all these Sherpas. There's double-double Sherpas.
Double-double Sherpa.
Double-double.
I can't hear the music today, so I'm like, I'm dancing the music in my head.
I just had it turned down so people, you know, because they were like, yeah, it's a little loud today.
See the difference? I'm like Alec Kay.
She lives on
in the Bronx Zoo.
So thank you guys for coming and hanging out. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. Make sure you can get the word out for us. So we need all the other Sherpas here to come play with us. Because we like, you know.
A little yellow, a little white.
One Sherpet is a lonely Sherpet. Two Sherpets is a party.
Two Sherpets is so a party. Is him just pushing that paint around and letting it be very streaky? This is this whole thing. It's a weird process. But that is what makes it look like marble glass, isn't it? Look at that fun thing that anybody could do. They just didn't know they could. I might wipe off my brush if I'm too loaded with pigment. And just go ahead and grab some more white here.
So Ian... He was like, just thought this painting is a bit like an old version of neoplasticism.
I love Ian. I think this is just one of those fun ones, but it really is about being okay. Right, and see, where I get in trouble is like following my own pattern, like where my branches are. So believe it or not, right here is another bit of blue glass. I'm going to have to get a smaller brush or I'm going to get stuck there.
I don't think Mondrian didn't do anything in plastic, though, did he?
Yeah.
I mean, in glass.
You know, it is very hard.
Because isn't that neoplasticism as
artists,
like Mondrian?
The greats tend to be prolific in the experiment. So you can see that I took a number two. Just to make sure that I didn't lose, right, my space there.
Where are you at?
And I might need to even use this small brush right here. And I'm going to just get the blue. But I don't want to lose. I'm just holding them now. I don't want to lose my marbling. The marbling is super important. I let purple get on there, but I don't care. And that's what you got to think about this glass is if other colors get on there, as long as they're not graying out the mix and they're still marbly, it's going to give you that stained glass kind of jam. Now we got to do the leaves. We don't do the leaves now. We'll forget where the heck they are. That is another big problem.
Well, they look kind of leafy, so that helps.
It does.
Whereas everything else could just be a piece of glass. And
now I'm going to take my phthalo green and my Australian Sienna. You could do your Indian yellow, or you could just do your cad yellow. And notice how I'm not mixing in the palette. They're beads. Beady, 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 beady. Beady, 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 beady. I just did a Buck Rogers joke for the three people who got it. And now I'm going to put this down.
All right.
And my dad, if my dad was watching, he would get that joke.
I'm going to put the...
So I want this to be an incredibly bright green. But it is important to me that these colors are very marbly. But y'all did not have any idea this is how this thing would be made. So I tricked you with the coloring. I tricked you into arting. I'm like that. I'll do that. I'm going to get a little of my blue and a little of my green. I haven't rinsed off my brush. I'm gonna make a darker one right here. Let's make a dark leaf. Isn't that fun? I don't know. I'm having fun. You might be
I think it's pretty awesome.
Out.
No, I think it's pretty cool. I'm just watching.
If I need more paint, I'm trying not to get water if I don't have to. But if I do, I'll just a tip of the brush into the water.
Is there a good alternative for Australian Sienna slash
Indian yellow?
Or other than Indian yellow?
Cad yellow deep, maybe.
Cad yellow deep. Okay.
Yeah. And it's not that important. You could do this all with cad yellow. I like it because it gives a certain warmth to the color.
Yeah.
And so it's worth it to me to say, hey, this is how I'm getting that. And you might want to do that, but don't, like, I'm going to come over here and I'll grab some cad yellow. Don't feel in some white. See, I just bead, 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 bead.
Yep.
Don't feel like you have to. In anything you're creatively doing, you have what you have in your art box. So don't let a missing tool.
Yeah.
Unless it's like, I don't have glass cutters for stained glass. But then there's people who paint stained glass. If you have a dream in your heart, go for it, I guess is my overall writing point. Get some yellow here. It's just still going.
Oh, there's a bunch of Buck Rogers fans out there.
So I think I'd do a really good impression, but, you know.
I am curious how many Stripes fans there are out there who got those references.
Yeah, John was like, I was cracking up. The whole thing had it for me, but then I was like, who knows if anybody else knows what we're talking about.
You know, it's
about.
Like if you came from that Mel Brooks era of, you know, comedy films and, you know.
I'm going to get some more green, some more blue, maybe some of this Australian Sienna. I'm going to just enjoy myself. What are you going to do?
What am I going to do? I'm going to enjoy chatting with everybody. When's the next art game, Anu says?
I think we're probably going to do ATCs before the art game, but they're all coming up pretty soon.
Mm-hmm.
We've got some ATC stuff because the February ATCs are already going. I just grabbed some white there because sometimes it's nice to add a white to your marble. See that?
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that interesting? Trick here is just not mixing.
No mixing. No blending.
No mixing.
You got to
No
be,
mixing.
What do
no,
we,
I just
we call it painterly.
Huh?
The painterly effect.
Painterly effect.
That's what we call it, painterly.
Hey, painterly. All right. So I'm almost through. I've got a couple. I have this leaf here.
Which one are you doing next?
But I think I'm going to do this leaf.
Yes. You're just making RoboCam run all over the place. You don't
I'm
know.
Sorry. I just want a dark leaf here. And the reason I do things like the leaves is, again, visually, the patterns can become overwhelming. You really get lost in what you have there. And then... And the color is what tells you what the object is. It's not the shape.
Gotcha.
In stained glass and in this type of work. So if the color has gotten away from you, then you won't know that this is a branch. Like, the branch won't show until I paint the branch colors in.
Oh.
The leaves don't really show as leaves until I paint the leaf colors in. And then the sort of muted other colors are what makes it look like you're looking through leaves and other things in atmosphere perspective. Glass artists are just crazy geniuses. I just want to say that right now for the one glass artist that hung in. Y'all are crazy geniuses. How they work out how our brains process Look at that. It's very nice. So I feel like we know where our leaves are.
Mm.
Right? That doesn't mean that we won't have greens, we won't have stuff, but the next thing I've got to put in or I will be lost in my project is my branch, which I'm going to move down to maybe a smaller brush. And I'm going to take my brown and maybe my Australian. You could do your cad yellow. You could grab a little white. And it doesn't matter on this if a little of the green or another color gets in it. Because interestingly enough, the marble glass is like that. But just basically, we want it to be brown. We need it to be brown.
Mm-hmm.
See? There's the first layer. It's the first leg. Yeah, just come right here. You could probably get some yellow ochre in here if you wanted to. Or even some burnt umber.
Yeah.
But you just want it to feel very swirly. Like, so I could grab some deep green and some brown. But mostly brown. Come right here. See how that's working? And it's through building this branch that this whole piece comes together. It's an interesting project we're doing today.
I'm actually been watching the you switching quite a bit here. I haven't been able to watch chat as much. They were just asking how Blendy's doing.
How is Blendy doing?
He's doing pretty good. He's been molting. He's been
molting, which makes him very grumpy.
He does. He becomes a grumpy dinosaur when he
like no sense of humor that lizard when he's molting. You come, you itch him, you go.
Yes.
You come, you itch, you leave. Kind of makes me think that T-Rex during certain times of the month be very demanding.
Mm-hmm.
Just saying. It's a whole nother story right there, right? Just getting different colors as I'm trying to tell the story of this branch. And again, every time you do it, yours will be a little different than mine because your marble will be different than my marble. And you know, you can get some white into the marble if you need it. As many marble glasses will have.
Ah. RoboCam is giving me a little
trouble.
So this
is really about just bravely putting paint down, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
And just being like, all right, this is what we're doing. What are we doing? We don't know. Keep putting paint down. Follow up. But now you can see the branch, can't you?
Sort of. I think so. There we go. I can see it now.
The branch shows now where until the color is applied, it doesn't. This actually tells a very important. This is a very important lesson. This could have been a quest about how art works because everything is just, you know, everything is just illusion on a flat surface. I'm going to offload my brush, which means I'm going to press it down and wipe off the extra paint. I'm going to grab some brown.
You have to slide that paint palette over just a touch. You're on the edge of the brown there. There we go. Perfect. Just
you can get some black if you want it. Just whatever you got to do, but just make sure it stays in the brown ranges.
Cover just a little bit.
Right? You can keep it marbled.
Now, could you use some sort of medium to make this look more like glass?
You mean transparent?
I don't know. I mean, maybe a clear glaze on over the top of it or make.
Well, I mean, I would think so. Glaze? I think you could probably do some interesting stuff.
I don't know.
To push this experience even further for the viewer, you know, the paint technique itself actually does quite a lot, believe it or not. Just like quite a lot. But you could sit there and do a bunch of stuff. Stuff like you could take pouring like string gel.
Uh-huh.
Or, and frost this painting with it.
Oh, wow. That would be all crazy, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it would look like there was resin on top of it. I guess you could actually also, because this is canvas board, pour resin over it.
You could. You just resin it.
Clear resin. But then your stone would also be under resin, which would confuse people. Ooh. So, you know, you have to know that that's like, uh-oh.
What?
Missing a line.
You're missing, what are you missing? What did you, I can see it. It's right there.
No, it's still
it's
there.
It's there.
Yeah, I just have to.
You have to put that in
there. It peaks a couple places, and then it disappears behind a bunch of stuff, and then it peaks a couple places. I'm telling you, man, you can get lost.
It's all vininess.
The vines are very tough to keep track of, and so that I would say is probably the hardest element to the whole piece. Is, you know, keeping track of the vines. Where are they at? But once you keep track of those, then you can, and you've got the blue in and the leaves and the grapes, and the rest of it goes in sort of very experientially.
Maddie was like, who's Blendy?
Hi, Maddie.
She's like, who is Blendy?
Blendy is our bearded chameleon. No, bearded? Veiled.
Veiled chameleon.
I don't know why I keep saying bearded.
I think someone else was confused earlier. They're like, why were you talking about Canadians and beards? So what was that about?
Because we live in Canada.
And it was hockey season.
When we moved, and we didn't know there was, like, this whole, like, don't cut my beard till my hockey team leaves. And so we thought just men in Canada just wore beards.
It took us a little while to...
Principal of the school. Just everybody.
Everybody just became bearded all at once.
And they were all in jerseys for a period of time. So it was just... We didn't know it was, like, seasonal.
It was like all of a sudden, all Canadians sprout beards.
Did you remember
beards.
It was like bright light at like 4 a.m? I just thought I was going to die
until
we got blackout curtains.
I remember I moved up before Cinnamon up to Canada when I was up there working on the Mech Warrior project. And that was crazy. I moved up a couple months before you. And
yeah.
It was like daylight when it should have been dark.
It was so bad. The trip to IKEA for the blackout curtains was maybe the best trip ever. It's like blackout curtains matter. So now can you see the branches?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, totally see the branches.
Yeah. But it's based on the color, isn't it? The color tells you what they are. So there we go. We got that in. Now we get to paint in the rest of the stuff, and that's pretty fun.
They thought Kevin the Kraken was our lizard.
What?
They thought Kevin the Kraken was the lizard.
Kevin the Kraken.
No, he's our imaginary friend.
Kevin is pretty awesome.
Kevin's pretty.
I just sometimes grabbed some yellow and some white. And just what was ever dirty around the yellow is just getting on here.
Yeah, you almost
do need
don't
worry
some,
about those things. I don't.
You almost do need paint by numbers to get the vines down, don't you?
You just need to keep track of what you were doing. I've got a little of my red and my yellow. And that's another fun part of this project is the warm colors in the faux glass. I'd be a really good stained glass designer if I didn't think I was going to bleed out my first day.
I did that little bit of stained glass.
You did, and you bled.
I did. I bled.
You bled a lot, man. Just saying.
I did, and I had all the gloves and the stuff.
It wasn't enough.
No.
It's not enough. Whatever you think is enough, it's not enough. Just trust me, it's not enough.
Glass is sharp,
y'all. Is sharp.
It is very sharp.
Very sharp. So I've got a little of the Australian. I'm going to come over here.
Oop, I'm going to come over here with you.
I'm just literally coloring this in. This is why I mean this is like a coloring page. It kind of makes sense now why it's a coloring page, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And get some white. And I'm just using these colors and these values to tell the story of what is happening here. Dead leaves. Distant sunlight peeking through things, you know.
Cheryl?
Like you do. And I just constantly changing up the colors. How's it working for everybody? Anybody being brave
going
enough to do
good.
This with me?
Oh my gosh, yeah. Everyone's having a great time here. So.
This is a let the paint. This is the beginning of impressionism here. Allow the paint to mix on the canvas. Right? That's what we're doing.
Yeah.
Isn't it fun?
I think so.
I'm just pulling paint as I need it. See, and just making sure that it's just coming along here. How are we doing on time, babe?
You have all the time in the evening.
That's true. Can't be as long as Eagle was. I love how I go from like 20 minutes to forever. Rinse account. I'm going to put some green up here. I want some green and some teals and stuff up top.
Now, they were, so Debbie was asking, where are you originally from, Sherpa?
Oh, gosh, that's, you know.
The moon.
The moon.
She's from the moon.
The moon. Well, I did some time. I did a very long stint in Southern California.
You spent most of your formative years in Southern California.
Shaw. Totally. Totally did.
San Diego. You were born.
San Diego, dude.
You were born on the top of a mountain.
Born at 14,000 feet, but my dad was a hang glider and a surfer, so we moved to San Diego. Because that's what you do when your dad's a surfer.
There's a llama
glider.
On your palate.
Huh?
There's a llama on your palate.
There's a llama?
There's a llama.
I see the llama.
You should paint some legs on the llama. Hey, llama legs.
Sorry. See, that's not mature. That's y'all are not mature. Distracting me with the cute llama on my palette. I love that everybody finds stuff on my palette. It's like one of my literally favorite things. I always wonder what happens to these weird types of lessons. Mm. I'm going to bring some of this color around here. I really kind of like its aquaness. It's like, it's sort of like La Belle Dame Merci. That's a long lesson, man. But then we see people who did it, and I'm like, dude, you fucking did it. Isn't this nice, this sort of turquoisey going around the grapes?
Yeah.
Yeah, I like it. I like it. I'm not sure this cut is realistic. But since this isn't real glass, I don't need to bleed out because I made a mistake. And that's what's important, right? Maybe, maybe not.
I was just reading over here in some of the chat here. Oh, so much going on. They love the llama.
Llama, llama, red pajama.
Well, let's see here. Let me scroll up and see what I had here. Thought there were some
kids went.
I've been watching. I've been following you over here. So we have traceables, and all those are available on Pinterest or on our website.
We really don't try to hide them for you, and I have no advice on how to resize them because I don't know your software. I don't know how you edit.
We'll see. You know, but yeah,
there's a lot of tutorials generally on how to use whatever you're using and change it up. You could just do this like whatever your printer had, just and put that on a canvas and just do it small.
Yeah, and we're gonna see if we can get some tutorials put together on doing some scaling and some printing for different people and put that up on the website.
We have a great PDF in Angeloni.
Yeah, we're gonna be putting
that was
some
by
stuff.
Somebody else. That was
actually it was one of our community members.
Yep.
Gail.
Was it Gail? So yeah.
So thank you. We have a lot of great stuff that comes together from our community. So thank you guys so much for that. That's looking pretty sharp. You're getting pretty close, huh? You're gonna get some coffee ID there. Is what you're gonna get humming away. I'm gonna de-mic her because I don't want to get like content ID. See, I pulled her mic away because I don't want content ID. Oh.
I'm telling you what, I could sing Taylor Swift right now and we wouldn't get pinged.
I'm telling you that they're stalking us. I think. They have not only are there robots
because we used actual songs, but like if I sing, they're not gonna. They don't care what I do.
No, no,
they don't care about me.
I'm afraid of the.
I'm gonna take some of my red over to this. You could take your red over to your CAD yellow if you wanted to. I could grab some of that too. Two yellows and a red.
What is content ID phobia? I don't know. I got it though.
Content ID phobia happens to YouTubers in general.
I think it's one. Yeah. Hashtag YouTube life. Oh, yeah. Kim, thank you very much. If you want to get any of the cool mugs that Cinnamon has been playing, you saw that mug that she had over there earlier. You can get that at the Art Sherpa website at shop.theartsherpa.com.
Yeah.
And we have
you
a whole bunch of cool stuff.
You too can have paint water, not paint water.
That's right. You too can have paint water. And we have shirts and mugs and there's some art game cards out there.
I don't know. I see well enough to do these small spaces anymore. Sometimes I get in there and I'm like scared. Scared. I'm so scared. Can't see no more.
There we go.
Can't see no more. Need just glasses. A I seriously do. I seriously do, folks. Does anyone else know what that's like? Sick of seeing my eye doctor. dentist, eye doctor, and the
don't
dentist.
Forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. That's right.
Oh, yeah, that thing. You know, subscribe. If you subscribe, go ahead and mash the bell. Otherwise, they won't tell you what's going on.
That's true. They do.
Because there's a new level of commit.
Mm-hmm.
Did you really mean it, or did you just get bullied into it? Mash the bell. Or you'll be like, wait, you were live? So how's that working for y'all?
Ooh, I think that's looking pretty good. I think that's looking pretty fantastic.
It can be fun. You really can't go wrong. It can be fun. And I like it. Just going along here, doing some things.
Now, if you guys have any questions or concerns or need any help with anything on the website, don't forget to, you can email me at help@heartparty.com. Or on the website, you can put in a trouble ticket and reach us that way.
Trouble.
We've got so much stuff going on the website. I just can't stress enough. We've got our polls going out there. We got chat going on out there. You can upload your images. You can let us know what wishes you want next. Now we've got that the wish forum going.
That's actually really useful. Please use the wish forum. That's so cool.
We're gonna have a Sherpa tracker up there for the RV. And we've got all sorts of cool stuff coming up there on the website. So definitely pay attention to that. And
good stuff.
Good stuff on the website.
Good stuff, definitely guys.
If you're not a member, as I have other, you know, as I'm looking for things to say, go plug the website. Go hang out at the website.
Website. Yeah. It's free. That helps.
It is free.
Why is all this art free, Mr. Cooney?
Because that's the sort of cornerstone of what we believe, is that art changes people and people change the world. And we want to give that away for free. Is that right?
That's pretty much the deal.
I got it.
That's pretty much the deal.
So, Sherpa, have you ever used some kind of outliners? I'm not sure. I don't think it's... I'm gonna have to.
Well, that's a harder question to answer. There, some kind of outliner.
Cerny, huh? Cairn.
That does not sound.
It's Cerne Relief Outliners with acrylic painting.
I don't feel like I have.
I don't know what those
Send
are.
Send me a picture on the Facebook, on the website somewhere, yeah, and I will check them out because I don't believe I've used that. I'm hitting some green right here.
Yeah, it's one of those things where it's, sometimes when I get stumped on an art material, it's because if I haven't heard of it, I haven't bought it from her for her, so it's not that I've.
Because I do a lot of my art hauls alone. Sometimes you got an art haul alone, man. You got an art haul alone. I got to stop watching John Wick. Is what's gotta stop starting. Just. I'll tell you what, that movie last night, John, babe, that was rough. Just saying. What happened? All the money in the world sometimes doesn't fix a bad thing. Give that girl a jacket. All right, so I'm just going here. This is when we get comments. What are you saying? How does this relate to painting? If you don't know that this stuff, seriously,
Mukhtar
go.
Ogar, I think, is what needs to be said. There's a whole bunch of Sherpets out here talking about the Horde, and they're playing Warcraft. So
are they on Etrig?
Uh-huh.
I do too. I got to get there with Donna.
There's more. They were out there playing the other night. They're having a whole blast out there, having a Sherpa slumber party. Say that 3 times fast.
Am I not at the slumber party? Because I go to sleep. Because I've been sick.
That's true. You've been under the weather a little bit.
We got to do Pepe soon.
We do. We need more Pepe.
Pepe. Not the evil Pepe. The good owl Pepe. We're not talking to no evil Pepe.
Nope.
No. I didn't even know about that. I was so disappointed about that. I was like, man.
Ooh.
Internet sometimes disappoints me. Does the internet ever disappoint you?
Man, there are some high-level Sherpets out there.
They really are. They're like gangsters. Am I allowed to say somebody tried to rob us? Didn't I?
Yeah, you. she said, can I tell them the secret right here live without you being able to edit it out? Now that
See,
I've already
this
told-
is how reality shows are real, because you wire somebody like me up, and I do genuinely forget how it all works.
And this is where...
Then you take off your shoe and flip a table in front of God and everybody, and you're like, I'm not really like that. Yeah, you is. You on camera.
Lisa's like, I'm not allowed to get sick anymore. You go right directly off of the pre-rehearsed script and go right to, we're just going to go live again tomorrow.
No, I thought that's what you were saying. Is that not? Are we not?
I guess we are now.
I don't know what's happening. I took some yellow and some red here, guys, and some white, and I'm going to get these very bright, high-range colors here. I shouldn't be allowed to do anything besides teach paint.
Yeah.
I swear, like, what makes me a good art teacher makes me bad at so many other things in life. It's just sometimes I just feel so ill-equipped to handle problems.
But you know what?
It's not a cream puff.
Well, I think what it is you know, we're really, really so, really enjoy doing this, you know? At the end of the day, we're just, like, this is all we want to do is just make more videos of this. So, it's really...
you guys all the paintings in the world.
So our motivation really is, like, how can we do more?
Doing the red and the yellow, if y'all are seeing this. Red and yellow! Right here. Warm it up. Give a pop of warmth, guys.
I like how it's very impasto there.
It needs to be, because you can't get the marbling without this impastoing in it.
I used a $2 word, so can you explain what that means?
You used the $2 word? Impasto means thick applications of paint.
Thick applications of paint.
Which you are never supposed to do with oils, but they keep doing. I love everyone sends me these, like, videos of this guy who's, like, frosting out oils, and I just want to go in his studio and have whole words with him. Just like, your collector will be dead before that dries. That's what I want to say. Dead. Oh. Their grandchildren might be dead before that thing is dry. I'll be, like, in a gallery and smell the wet paint. And John, like, has to put a gag over my mouth.
There's a flower underneath the llama now.
Huh?
There's a flower under the llama.
There is a flower under... Do I need to paint a llama? Y'all are seeing some llamas in the world, aren't you? You guys are like, llamas. Llamas everywhere. There's so many llamas. Somebody help me, the llamas are everywhere.
So, Rhonda would like to know, what is gouache?
Gouache
And how do you pronounce it?
Gouache is a water-based paint. It's a similar product to watercolor, except watercolor is transparent, whereas gouache is quite opaque. Gouache layers, so you can put white over another color with gouache, whereas you really can't with watercolor. And it's traditionally, you would see gouache used in, like, medieval illumination and things like that.
Yeah, didn't it have some sort of different kind of media, like, the big thing about gouache is it's carrier, right? It has a different medium that... Or I guess
it's I mean, like, then watercolor.
Yeah, it's like watercolor.
I think that's
uses
possibly it.
Gum
I'm
Arabic.
Trying to remember off the top of my head if it's different than gum Arabic, but what is mainly different about it is that it is opaque.
Yeah,
it is not transparent.
I'll have to.
It's a high pigment load. You can just check that real quick. We'll look that up for you real quick.
I have to reach over. I
feel like I messed that up right there. But we're gonna just go with it. Come back and fix it with the black paint. When you have it go wrong, come back and fix it with the black paint. Okay, see, we're getting there.
You're getting it close.
We're getting there, guys. We're getting there. And when we get there, what will happen? We don't know. We don't know. We've just got to tell the story of this vine. Don't we?
Yeah.
In the world, this vine. Get some yellow. You can tint.
Oh, no, I guess it uses, its binder is usually dextrin or gum arabic as well.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, let me slide up here. I'm over here reading the Wikipedia on gouache.
You're like on, John's
like, what is it?
What is it? Yeah, no, it's just very opaque. You'd see it, like, illuminating scrolls and stuff like that. Remember, we did that in the SCA.
We did a lot of that. So I guess I knew it was an older one, but I'll read up on it a little
later.
Nice. Yeah.
And there's some really good gouaches out there still, and it's a very fun medium. And you can do some really incredible, enlightened art projects with it, in my opinion. In my humble opinion. Yeah. underused product. Not really a big call for gouache tutorials, though, on YouTube. People are like, where's the gouache? Like, remember, where's the beef lady? I'm almost done.
I know. It's looking so cool.
I gotta fix some things, but mostly I'm like, what hey, I'm doing pretty good.
What are you fixing? Everything looks so good.
There's a couple places. Just gotta get it and get her done, Mr. Cooney. You gotta get her done. And you can see why I kind of enjoy the two yellows.
I like how it how you see the white mixing together with the yellow on there, and it kind of makes it all painterly.
And it needs to be, because that's how it feels like the marble glass that you see in these types of glass works. And that's how you really create that sort of... See how that's getting to be like a glass effect, and the fact that there's very light pieces in dark pieces, it just gives it that sense that there's light coming through. Very important to creating the illusion of what is happening. See?
Oh, I see, yeah.
Yeah. We're creating the illusion. All right. Now, what you can do, if you like, if you want,
what are you doing?
You can go back through, if your thing is not clogged, because you didn't close it properly, that's not clogged, you can go back through with your now completely abused, why do I do that?
I don't know. Why do you do that, Sherpa?
No, now I have to take it to the spa.
What are you doing? I'm going to go over here and I'm going to show everybody what you're doing to your brush there.
I'm trying to. So it hasn't completely cured dried in there, but it's dried hard, and so I'm trying to work into the...
I'm going to have to save that one.
Now
I'm going to the spa.
And then I'm going to have to do some stuff to get it back. But regardless, I have fresh paint out. One thing that you can do if you want to at this stage is define some of your lines.
Put some touch up back in there.
That you might have lost. Where you're like, hey, that's cool. Right? Yeah. Maybe you led something more. It's just a good time to like look for stuff and clean it up. These... For the few of you that are, you know, maybe sort of selling your work, these do pretty well. They really do. They sell pretty quick. People really like it. You know, it can be difficult to get stained glass and collect stained glass, but everybody has a love for stained glass. And when people run into these paintings, it generally delights them. I find if you can delight collectors... Right? That you'll do pretty well.
And so you're just going right back over the black line there.
Yeah, I'm just anywhere I feel like, you know, it could use a little more letting. And I'm just sort of showing how that strengthens it. Of course, I brutalized my brush, so my brush is not being behaved. Behave. Have Austin Powers moment here. But you can see where I'm putting in those lines.
Oh, yeah, it really strengthens it up.
It strengthens it up. It again reinforces. I won't make you guys sit through me relining the whole thing, because that would be cruel and unusual punishment.
I don't know. I think it's kind of neat just watching. I like watching you paint.
Do you?
Well, I mean, it's a good thing, because that's what I do all day.
It is. Even when you guys aren't here, he has to watch me paint, just so y'all know. Because I do several a day.
I watch more paint dry than anybody else I know.
Several paintings every day.
Maybe the guys at Golden or Matisse, maybe
they watch a lot of paint dry.
They probably watch as much paint dry as me.
They watch a lot of paint dry. Golden's really trying to do some interesting stuff lately.
Yeah.
So that's Matisse. Seen some cool stuff out of Matisse. Definitely worth following all of them on social media.
Mm-hmm.
Many, many cool pins and posts and tweets. And really seriously, given the condition of Twitter and social media now, I'd rather follow art. Where am I at? I'm on the art page. Where everything is happy and colorful. Not to be judgy, I'm just saying. You know, I really, really enjoy when Golden just releases a new color or Matisse releases a new color.
So much good social media.
It is. It is. I can share it.
I love all the pictures and the pretty use of paint that they do.
Yeah. We poured some stuff. Oh, I'm so into the paint pouring right now.
I mean, if you had an unlimited budget for paint, what could you do? Well, I'll pour 30 gallons onto the ground and see how it looks.
Dude, it's really fun, though.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Cells and all that, that's some fun stuff, straight up.
If I had, that's what I would do if I had limited access to paint. It would be just massive paint
pours. I'm not
pours.
Saying it was a cheap project. I'm just saying it's one we could probably do on the show one time at least.
That'd be cool.
Get
a bunch of pot paint.
Hmm?
Get like...
Well, that's what dirty pours are for, I think, is that you for the paint you pour out... You then I'm still like kind of figuring out the culture of paint pouring.
Yeah, we got to learn more about it.
Because it's developed around me. It's gone beyond splattering paint at canvas. I'll tell you that right now. It's kind of cooler than a magic trick.
So now apparently you have a hippo llama forming over there.
A hippo llama.
It's got wings. It's kind of like a hippogriff, but it's a llama with wings. They're much less wise.
So you guys can see how going back and strengthening your lines can help define this piece, right, more significantly.
Mm-hmm.
You know, even the glass, like how this glass sits in the window chamber. I made up that isn't really here. Now I'm all caffeinated, and then we got to figure out what I'm watching until I calm down. I think I've got something taped. This is why we don't do late shows, because Mama never goes to sleep. Mama's like, oh... We could paint this. Oh, wait. We should pour paint. No, wait, John, come here. I have an idea. Let's do this cool art thing. All right. I feel like we're kind of getting there. What do you guys think?
They think it's pretty awesome.
I think it is, too. I'm going to rinse out this poor abused brush that's going to have to go soak in some alcohol.
Mm.
Oh, maybe some Jack's. I'll try Jack's
Lube. Well, I think I can get that out of there.
You acting like you even do.
It's a Red Bull llama.
Okay, give that to me for a second and put that up on the screen.
There's a little llama.
Okay. See, this is what you should never, ever do. But, see, now you've...
you've added the llama time.
It did. Well, because you guys started it. Y'all started it. And when you guys start these things, you should realize that...
Now, what brush were you using there to outline with? That was
this one right here?
Yeah.
Or the other one?
The other one you were using earlier.
I'm using a Sterling Studio Bright number 0.
There's a 0 Bright. What are you using right there?
This is a Silver Crystal Bright.
Okay. So you're just playing around there before we go.
Yeah.
Putting some llama-ness in.
I'm just giving him some llama legs, right? I mean, he's a llama now. Look at that.
Oh.
You didn't even know I knew that by heart, did you? You didn't even know that I knew that by heart. And see, this is his headdress. He's in traditional gear. Wait, there we go. Because I can't be stopped. You can't limit me. I can make this work. By the way, I am the queen in my house at the doodle game.
So we're
if you didn't know, my kids have been trying to stump me for years with scribbles. Have you guys ever played that game where your kids do a scribble and then you got to make art out of it? There's a real famous artist that actually did that with their kids and created a whole show.
So why is it you should never do this?
Why?
Just start painting. You said you should never do this and then started painting the head of the llama.
I don't know. You should actually always do this.
You should always do this.
You should always have fun and see if you can.
Because they're like, what are we never to do? And then I'm like, I don't know.
I don't know.
I'm confused because I was like, I have no idea what they're asking
about. I'm just saying that, you know, I think I was trying to use reverse psychology.
You should. They think maybe you should draw a clock.
Wait.
Wait. The 6 goes at the bottom.
Okay, dyslexia strikes. Okay, I'm good, right? That's a clock, right? The numbers are all on one side. All I'm saying is I did a llama.
Thank you guys for coming and hanging out with us. I mean, wow. You guys are so awesome. Thank you for coming and being with us. And, you know, don't forget to share your stuff with us. We really love to see these paintings. You know, you can come out to TheArtSherpa.com. You know, we've got our wish group out there, or a place where you put wishes. We have our chat. We just love hanging out with you guys.
We'll play some sort of, we'll do something interesting art-wise tomorrow night.
Yeah.
Maybe ATC something, art game something.
We love you guys. So I'm going to go over here. I'm going to find all the right buttons to say goodnight. And, you know, I think that's what we're going to do, isn't it? They're going to, we're going to come along something somewhere. What are you doing over there? You're just being crazy.
Too much coffee late at night.
Too much coffee late at night.
And that girlfriend. Oh, you know man. Her.
Well, guys, we love you guys. It was really nice seeing you guys. Thank you for coming and hanging out with us. As always, we love you guys.
See you at the easel really soon.
Bye-bye.
You can kill your camera. I mean, it's like right on your good camera.